Today, this is your Exodus. You are officially released. Now sing it for me, DeAndrea.
Yeah. lives.
Disconnected.
Glory to God in the highest, new revelation. I hope that all of y'all had a merry, merry Christmas, because Jesus is the reason for the season. And he is the reason why we are in the sanctuary this Sunday morning, to lift up the name of the Lord and to praise the God of our salvation. So let's give our God a hand clap of praise. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. My soul shall make her boast in the Lord. The humble shall hear thereof and be glad. Oh, magnify the Lord with me, saints, and let us all exalt his name together. Because God is greatly and worthy to be praised. Amen, somebody. And let's thank God for the pastor and the great teacher of this house, the Reverend Edward C. Turner, for all that he does for the people of God. Amen, somebody. And we'd like to thank all those by way of Facebook Live and YouTube. We thank God for your support. And we thank God for using us to allow us to meet your spiritual needs this Sunday morning. We pray that something will be encouraged and inspired this Sunday morning to edify you and to keep you charged this Sunday morning for the Lord. And we thank God for allowing you to meet us here at the Revelation, New Revelation Missionary Baptist Church, located at 3140 West 21st Avenue, here in the fair city of Gary, Indiana. So may God bless you and prosper you as you continue to serve the Lord in your year of 2021. Let's give God a hand clap of praise one more time for what God is doing here at the New Revelation Missionary Baptist Church. Because we are here to lift up his name. We're here to praise him, saints. And we're here to glorify the Lord. So we're going to open up our hearts this Sunday morning as we enter into the last Sunday of December and the last month of the year of 2020. To thank God for what he has done, what he's going to do, and what he's already doing for us here in the new year. Amen, somebody. So let's praise God one more time. Let's give our God a hand clap of praise, and let's celebrate the Lord for his greatness and mercy. Amen. We're going to ask our deacons to come with a scripture and prayer. Then following will be our praise and worship by our New Revelation praise team. God bless y'all.
Good morning. Good morning, Holy Spirit. Good morning, New Revelation, Missionary Baptist Church. Our scripture is coming from Psalms 107. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endureth forever. Let the redeemed of the Lord say whom he hath redeemed from the hand of the enemy, and gathered them out of the lands from the east and from the west, from the north and from the south. They wandered in the wilderness in a solitary way. They found no city to dwell in. Hungry and thirsty, their soul faded in them. Then they cried unto the Lord in their trouble, and he delivered them out of their distress. And he led them forth by the right hand. By the right way, that they might go to a city of habitation. Oh, that men would praise the Lord for his goodness and for his wonderful works to the children of men. For he sacrificed the longing soul and filleth the hunger soul with goodness. Such as sit in darkness and in the shadow of death, being bound in affliction and iron, because they rebelled against the word of God and condemned the counsel of the Most High. Therefore he brought down their heart with labor, and they fell down, and there was none to help. Then they cried unto the Lord in their trouble, and he saved them out of their distress. He brought them out of the darkness and the shadow of death, and broke their bonds asunder. Oh, that men would praise the Lord for his goodness and for his wonderful works to the children of men. I read you Psalms 107, verses 1 through 15. God's word has already been blessed. Thank you.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Blind, but now I see. Eternal God, our Father, come once again, Father, your weak and humble servant, Father. Realize that thou art weak, but thou art strong, Father. Father God, first we thank you right now, Father God, for looking beyond our faults and you saw our needs, Father. Father God, ask you to forgive us of our sins also right now, Father. Because you allowed us to lay down last night, and as we laid down last night, we slept and slumbered all night, Father. But you kept your angels around about us, and we woke up this morning with a brand new day, Father. We thank you right now, Father, for the day we never saw before and never see again, Father. Father, we thank you for being clothed in the right mind also, Father God. We thank you for the blood running woman out of veins also, Father. Father God, we just thank you right now, Father God, for being so good to us, for letting good to ourselves, Father. Father God, we want to thank you right now, Father, for each and every one that's assembled here on the sound of my voice, Father. As you bless each individual one by one and name by name, Father. As you to go with us and stand by us also right now, Father God. We just need you every minute and every hour, Father. We can't do nothing without you, my Father. And you will live and you will die, Father. That's your blessing right now, Father God, on those that are running late to certain churches right now, Father God. That's your guide on safety sound our way inside, Father. Father God, we thank you right now, Father God, for allowing us to see this last Sunday of the year right now, Father God. You brought us a mighty long way, Father, from the first Sunday this year to down all the way to the last Sunday this year, Father. And we thank you, Father, for being good to us right now, Father. That's your blessing on our pastor of this church, Father. That's your pop over building inside the building where it's torn down. As you to keep a head around them, have mercy right now, Father God. As you to bless ones right now, Father God, that don't know you for the path of their sin right now, Father God. Bless that man, that woman, that boy, girl, that walking around in darkness right now, Father God, that have backslid and turned their back on you, Father God. But you can turn it back around right now, Father God. You can make things new again, Father, because you got all power, hell, roof in your hand right now, Father God. But just thank you, Father, for all the churches, open doors for worship service this morning, Father. As you bless all over that sick among us right now, Father God. Something not feeling well, but use the doctor to write all our prescriptions right now, Father God. You made it and you know all about us right now, Father God. So we thank you, Father. We thank you for the praise that are going to praise you this afternoon right now, Father God. As you look on them right now, stand by right now, Father God. Anoint their voices with wisdom and knowledge right now, Father God. It's all about you, it's not about us right now, Father God. Father God, we're all down here right now, Father God, waiting on you to come back again, Father. And we're looking forward to you, seeing you again right now, Father God. As you, Father God, look on the ones that have lost loved ones, Father. Somebody heartbroken and somebody shedding tears this morning. But you can mend a broken heart and make things new again, Father. We just thank you, Father God, for being good right now, Father. We just raise our heads to you right now, Father God, because all the help comes from you right now, Father God. We can't do nothing without you, my Father. As you right now, Father God, they look on the ones right now, Father. They'll know you for the path they're seeing right now, Father. Somebody on bending knees right now, crying out your name right now, Father. As you hear the cry of your little children right now, Father. Because we're crying out to you right now, Father. Because we know no other help but you right now, Father God. You all the help we need right now, Father God. As you bless those right now, Father God, that's downtrodden right now, Father. Somebody suffering right now, Father God, with high blood pressure, diabetes, and some have mental health right now, Father God. As you look on them right now, Father, also right now, Father. Father God, as you look on the ones right now, Father God, in the far distant land right now, Father God. Right now, Father God, the church doors are swinging on right now, Father God. The saints coming in right now, Father. As you bless them all right now, Father God. And Father God, one day when it's your to call, we all get answered one day, Father. We don't know when, we don't know where, we don't know how, Father. But one day in our dying hour, we're going to say our last prayer and sung our last song. And we go into the room, not return again, Father. We're just looking for a place in your kingdom. But you can tell us, seven well done, seven well done. So when the saints come marching in, we all want to be in that number. So this is our prayer in your son, Jesus' name, amen, amen. Amen.
Well, praise the Lord, somebody. Praise the Lord, somebody up in here today. Hallelujah. Do we have any victorious people in the house today? If you're victorious, come on, make some noise for the Lord this morning. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I said, do I have any victorious people in the house?
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Let the redeemed of the Lord say something. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It's a song that we already know. Come on, put your hands together. We got the victory this morning, don't we? Come on, y'all. Let's sing this together. Goes like this.
I've got evidence. I've got confidence. I'm a conqueror. I know that I win. I know who I am. God wrote it in His plan for me. Oh, 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 oh. My name is. is victory. Anybody name is victory on today? Oh, 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 oh. My name is victory. I want y'all to sing with us. Come on, y'all, say it.
I've got confidence.
I'm a conqueror.
I'm a conqueror.
I know that I'll win.
I know that I'll
because
win.
I know who I am.
I know who
anybody
I
know who they
am.
Are? Because God wrote it in his plan.
God wrote it in his plan.
Say it one more time. Come on, I've got evidence.
I've got evidence. I've got confidence. I'm a conqueror. I know that I win.
Know.
I know who I am.
Because God wrote it.
God wrote it in his plan.
To say this next part with him. Watch this. God gave me
authority
to conquer the
enemy.
He wrote in my
destiny
that my name is
victory.
He said I would
overcome.
I know I've
already won.
He wrote in my
destiny
that my name is
victory. I know
because God wrote it.
God wrote it in his plan.
For me. Sing, oh,
oh,
my name.
My name is victory.
Oh, oh, oh,
oh, my name is victory.
I know my identity, my name is victory. I know my identity, my name is victory. Say,
I know my identity.
My name is,
my name is
victory.
Victory.
I know
my identity.
My name
is
victory.
Victory.
Oh, I know
my identity.
My name is
victory.
I know
my identity.
My name
is
victory.
Victory.
Come on, say victory.
Victory.
That's my name.
That's my name.
Victory.
Victory.
I know
who I am.
Victory.
That's my name.
That's my name. Sing victory.
Victory.
I know
who I am.
Come on, y'all, say, I know
who I am.
Lift your voice, say, I know
who I am.
I know
who I am.
Last time, say, I know
who I am.
Come on, now, you got the victory this morning. Put your hands together for the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Yeah, yeah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We can say it one more time real quick. I know my identity. My name is Victory. Say,
I know my identity.
My name is
my
me. One more time, I know.
I know my identity.
My name
is
Victory.
Victory.
Say victory.
Victory.
That's my name.
That's my name.
Victory.
Victory.
I know. Say victory. That's my name.
That's my name.
Say victory.
Victory.
I know
who I am.
Hallelujah.
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 It is a privilege and an honor to be here today, the last Sunday in 2020.
Yes.
And I thank God for the victory. Hallelujah.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Because it wasn't because of me. It's all because of him. Hallelujah. The Bible says in John 16, Jesus was talking to the disciples and he said, in this world, you will see trouble, but take heart. That means don't be afraid. But I have overcome the world. That means he's got the victory. And so because he's got the victory and I'm in him and he's in me, that means that I've got the victory.
Yeah.
So the song says this: who can stand against the Lord? Nobody can.
Nobody.
Who can stand against our King?
Nobody
can. The victory belongs to Jesus. Let's go higher.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Who can stand against him? No one can.
Yeah.
No one will. Yeah. Who can stand against our King? No one can. And no one will. Oh, victory belongs to Jesus. Victory belongs to him.
Hey.
Oh, victory belongs to Jesus. Victory belongs to him. Who can stand against the Lord? Find my victory in you. Forever victorious, forever we win. I find my victory in you. You belong to Jesus. Victory belongs to Jesus. Victory belongs to Jesus. Victory belongs to him. Victory belongs to Jesus. Victory belongs to Jesus. Victory belongs to Jesus. Victory belongs to him. Victory belongs to Jesus. Victory belongs to Jesus. Victory belongs to Jesus. Victory belongs to him. Victory belongs to Jesus. Victory belongs to Jesus. Victory belongs to Jesus. Victory belongs to him. Victory belongs to Jesus. Victory belongs to Jesus. Victory belongs to Jesus. Victory belongs to him. Victory belongs to Jesus. Victory belongs to Jesus. Victory belongs to Jesus. Victory belongs to him. Victory belongs to Jesus. Victory belongs to Jesus. Victory belongs to Jesus. Victory belongs to him. Victory belongs to Jesus. Victory belongs to Jesus. Victory belongs to Jesus. Victory belongs to him.
My God.
Yeah.
The victory belongs to Jesus. You don't gotta fight for it.
It belongs to him.
Hallelujah. Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Oh,
the victory belongs to Jesus. You're too busy looking for the victory. You've already got it because he's in you and you're in him. So you don't gotta fight for victory. Just fight from it, by it.
Victory belongs to Jesus. Victory belongs to him.
Oh,
oh, oh, victory belongs to Jesus.
Yes, he does.
Victory belongs to him.
Victory belongs to you.
Yeah.
Victory belongs. It belongs to him.
My God.
Hey. Victory belongs. It belongs to him. Victory belongs. It belongs to him.
Victory belongs. Victory belongs.
It belongs to
him. Victory belongs.
It belongs to him.
Victory belongs.
It belongs to him. One more time.
Victory belongs to him.
If my grandmother was alive, she would
victory
say this.
Belongs.
Victory is mine. Victory today is
mine. Victory
belongs. Victory, victory. Victory is mine. My grandmother, she couldn't victory sing, but she always had a song in her spirit. She said, victory today.
Him.
Hold on for a second, y'all. Victory, victory is mine. That's what she said. Can we go there for just a minute? I'm sorry. Victory today, I feel that thing. It's mine. Oh, she said, I told her, say, to tell you something else. The comforter. Joy. Joy is mine. Joy is mine. I feel that thing. Joy. Joy is mine. Joy. Joy is mine. Hard to say no. Get you. Joy, joy today. Can we stand for prayer? It's mine. Woo. With joy, I also got peace. Hey! Peace is mine. Peace is mine. Peace, peace today. It's mine. Hallelujah. I told Satan, you better get thee behind. Because peace, peace today is mine. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Yeah. Hallelujah, Jesus. Yeah. Hallelujah, Jesus. Yeah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. God, we thank you, God. We adore you, God. We acknowledge you, God. We made it, oh God. And it wasn't because of any goodness of our own. We made it because of you, oh God. It could have been us, oh God, but it wasn't. We could have been in that storm, but it wasn't us. We could have been in that number, but it wasn't us. So, God, right now we say thank you, God. God, we lift up your holy name. God, we extol you, God. God, we exalt you, God. You didn't let it come our way, oh God. So, God, we say thank you. We've witnessed people in depression. We've witnessed people die. We've heard of friends losing family members. But it wasn't us, oh God. So God, we say thank you, oh God. We lift your name, oh high, oh God. We bless your holy name, oh God. Regardless of who we've been, no matter what we've done, every day that you gave us, you chose to love us, oh God. So we take this moment to love you back, oh God. To give you glory. To give you honor. To bless your holy name, God. There is no one like you, Jesus. So we lift up your holy name, oh God, and we thank you for this moment, oh God. We thank you for your son and his sacrifice. We thank you for the Virgin Mary for birthing this baby. We thank you that he went to the cross. We thank you that he hung, bled, and died. So we lift up his name, oh God. Holy Spirit, come into this place. Saturate this place, oh God. Have your way in this place, oh God. Move by your Spirit, oh God. Move by your Spirit, oh God. Have your way in this place, oh God. We thank you for victory. We thank you for joy. We thank you for peace. We thank you that it wasn't us. We thank you that it wasn't our loved ones. We thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
We give your name glory and honor. Every weight that we've been carrying, we let it go. We're not going to go into 2021 with the same woes of 2020. We let it go, oh God. And we will forever trust you. We will forever give your name praise. We will forever give your name glory. We will forever give your name honor. We thank you, Jesus. 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 We seal this prayer in the only name that has power to make demons tremble.
Yes, Lord.
We thank you, oh God. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray.
Come on, somebody continue to praise the Lord in here. Hallelujah. The victory belongs to him. Victory belongs to him. Now watch this. We put our trust in him. Yeah. We put our trust in him. Yeah. The victory belongs to him. Victory belongs to him. Come on, y'all, help me say victory belongs. Victory belongs. The victory Victory belongs to him.
Victory belongs.
We put our trust in you, Lord. We put our hope in you, Lord. Hallelujah. Yeah. Victory belongs.
To him.
The victory belongs.
To him.
Say it one more time. Victory belongs to him.
Victory belongs to him.
Now come on, put your hands together for the Lord. If you got the victory, put your hands together for the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hey. Because the victory today is mine. The victory is mine. Because I did tell Satan to get thee behind me. Because joy is mine. Peace is mine. Long suffering is mine. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. We give you glory today, God. We give you honor today, God. We give you all the glory today, God. Yes, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Victory shall be mine. Victory today is mine. Hallelujah. Now come on, we need everybody to participate in this next song. We're going to dance a little bit on today. Hallelujah. Come on. Put your hands together. Here we go. Oh, victory, victory shall be mine.
Oh, victory, victory shall be mine.
Victory
shall be mine.
They said, oh, victory, victory shall be mine.
Oh, victory, victory shall be mine.
If
I hold my peace, let the Lord find my battle.
Victory,
victory, victory shall be mine.
Oh, joy, joy shall be mine.
Oh, joy, joy shall be mine.
If I hold
my peace, let the Lord find my battle.
Joy
shall be mine.
Oh, say love shall be mine.
Oh, love shall be mine.
If I hold
my peace, let the Lord find my battle.
Love
shall be mine.
All right, y'all, one more. Peace shall be mine.
Oh, peace.
Come on, choir members, that out there.
If I hold my peace, let the Lord find my battle.
Peace
shall be mine.
Back to the top. Oh, victory shall be mine.
Oh, victory shall be mine.
If I hold
my peace, let the Lord find my battle.
Victory, yeah.
Victory shall be mine.
Come on, put your hands together. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Anybody feel like dancing on today? If you got the victory, you ought to want to give the Lord some praise this morning. Hallelujah. Oh, say victory.
Victory.
I got the victory in Jesus. I told Satan,
victory.
Get thee behind.
Victory.
I told the devil,
victory.
Get thee behind. Victory. I've got the victory.
Victory.
Oh, victory.
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 I told the devil.
Victory.
Get thee behind.
Victory.
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 Oh, victory.
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 Oh, victory.
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 Come on, say, if I hold. If I hold my peace,
let the Lord
be my
hope. If I hold my peace, let the Lord be my
hope.
If I hold my peace, let the Lord be my
hope.
If I hold my peace, let the Lord
be
my
hope.
If I hold my peace, let the Lord be my
hope.
Victory, victory shall be mine.
Look, I need somebody to dance for me in the aisle right now. I wish I could dance for myself. I need somebody to dance for me right now. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. The Lord is good, and His mercy endures forever. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. I will bless the Lord at all times, and His praises shall continually be in my mouth. Hallelujah. Oh, victory. That's victory.
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 You got the victory.
Victory.
I've got the victory.
Victory.
You got the victory.
Victory.
I've got the victory.
Victory.
You got the victory.
Victory.
You got the victory.
Victory.
You got the victory.
Victory.
I've got it.
Victory.
Oh, you got it.
Victory.
Yeah.
Victory.
Yeah.
Victory.
Victory.
Victory!
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 Come on, put your hands together. Come on, if I hold, my peace, let the Lord.
If I hold, my peace, let the Lord.
If I hold,
my peace, let the Lord.
If I hold,
my peace. Let the Lord
if
my
hope,
let the Lord
victory.
My victory, victory shall be mine.
Come on, somebody rejoice in the Lord on today. If you got the victory, come on, rejoice in the Lord today. The Bible says, praise Him on the string instruments and organ. But we're going to let the new sisters play for a minute. Come on, come on, come on. Thank you. If you know you have the victory, somebody shout victory. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, I don't know about you, but when you look at me, you're looking at a testimony. And the only thing I'm saying is that I have the victory, that I'm an overcomer, that I am a deliverer. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Let's put our hands together.
Yeah.
And thank God. The reason I have the victory has already been said, because my victory is in Jesus. And because he won, I already won. Amen. Because he's the champion, I just happen to be on the team. Amen. Let's put our hands together and thank God for this praise ensemble, this singing aggregation. Amen. For they have truly led us in worship on this day. Amen. These musicians, amen, and all that have shared with us. My, 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 this is the last Sunday. My, my, my. Millions didn't make it, but I was one of the ones that did. And if I don't make it to 2021, I gotta praise, hey, in my heart. Hey, hey. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, don't have to wait till New Year's Eve to celebrate the ball going up. Amen. Amen. But I can celebrate right now. For God is worthy. Worthy to be praised.
Amen, amen. So good to see your faces in the place where we can come and worship the Lord, the God of our salvation. Amen, amen. For truly he's worthy to be praised. Anybody believe he's worthy? He's worthy to be praised. For the Bible says from the rising of the sun to the setting of the same, the Lord's name is worthy to be praised. And I'm just excited about this opportunity. No matter how heavy this year has been, God is still worthy. We know God is not governed by time. Time is just for us. We're governed by Chronos, but God is governed by Kairos. Amen. That's God's time. Amen. Chronos is man's time, but we thank him for his grace and his mercy, how he has favored us, even on today. I'm ready to go, but I'm not ready to go. And even on this morning, I got news that individuals I know have gone on to be with the Lord. People have left here this year. Individuals have stuck their sword in the sand of time. As the deacon would say, the study war no more. But I'm still here. And because I'm still here, I'm going to do what God has created me to do. One of those things is worship him. Praise his name. Every time I get a chance, I'm going to worship him. Hallelujah, God. You're worthy. For God has been better than good. He's been merciful. He's been gracious. He's given me what I didn't deserve. And I'm grateful. I'm thankful. I appreciate him. I adore him. I magnify him. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. You're worthy. You're a great God. You're an awesome ruler. You're the forgiver of my sin, the sustainer of my mind. Thank you, God. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, how I love you. You kept me when I didn't want to be kept. Thank you, God. When I didn't know how I was going to make it, you made a way. Thank you. Oh, I love you. We love him. We adore him. Thank you. Amen. Amen. I know I'm not as old as some of you, but when I look over my life, I realize things don't have to be as well as they are. I don't have to be as healthy as I am. I do funerals all the time, but I thank God. That's why for me to live is Christ, to die is gain. But as long as I live, I'll hold up the bloodstained banner. As long as I live, I'll hasten until his throne. Sometimes you just cry tears of joy. There's nothing going on, amen. Nothing wrong, but God has just been good. Thank you. Sometimes it seems like thank you is not good enough. I'm still here because of the grace of God. Let's put our hands together and let's thank him one time. There is a passage that I want to share with you. Hallelujah. Passage of scripture found in the letter to the Hebrew church. Some of us are familiar with it. The first three verses I'll read in your hearing. Look up on the screen, and if you can stand with us. First three verses from the New International Version of the Bible read like this. Therefore, since we are surrounded by such a great cloud of witnesses, let us throw off everything that hinders and the sin that so easily entangles us. And let us run with perseverance the race marked out before us. Fixing our eyes on Jesus, the pioneer and perfecter of faith. For the joy set before him, he endured the cross, scorning the shame, and sat down at the right hand of the throne of God. Consider him who endured such opposition from sinners, so that you will not grow weary and lose heart. In the King James Version, it says, lay aside every weight and sin that so easily beset you. Amen, somebody. I want to share today, it's time to lose some weight. It's time to lose some weight. Some of y'all got quiet. Amen. Especially after these holidays. you have eaten as you prepare, Deacon McGee, amen. I heard you this morning, amen. To go into the next phase of your life. It's time to lose some weight. One thing I learned about weight is easy to gain. Y'all stay with me, amen. It's easy to gain, and before you know it, you have picked up some pounds. I'm not gonna say a few, I'll just say some. You have picked up some pounds just because you're going about your day-to-day activity. And that's just like our lives. It's very easy for us to gain some weight in our mind and our spirits. Amen, somebody. Especially after the events of this year, some of us have went through this year just living our lives, and our spirits have become heavy because of the weight of the world. Y'all stay with me, amen. People have died. People don't have the adequate resources in order to live. Wait. Depression, amen, wait. Got a virus out here, wait. Don't know if you want to take the vaccine or not, wait. A whole lot of weight comes with just living. And a lot of us have been weighted down this year by the cares of the world in our personal and public life. Whole lot of weight, depressed, discouraged, deflated, derailed, discombobulated. We just don't know what to do. A whole lot of weight, heavy walking around, heavy trying to go to work, heavy trying to raise your children, heavy trying to go about day. It's time to lose some weight because I didn't got heavy. It's easy to pick up this weight. You weren't trying to pick it up. All you were doing was just living. I wish I had some witnesses, amen. And just as like life, amen. You're not trying to pick up the weight, but when you turn on the television, when you get a phone call, when you look at Facebook, when you look at the Twitter, when you look at all of the social media outlets, it seems like you get weight on you. Even with your own life, amen. Weight. Laid there. Told y'all at the beginning of the year, didn't know what was going on with my body. Weight. Amen, somebody. Don't know what you're going to do. Don't know what the diagnosis would be, but a whole lot of weight we carry in our mind and in our spirits. Amen. Some of y'all in this pandemic have picked up some people. Maybe before the pandemic. You've been carrying the weight of people that has caused you to be heavy. Amen, somebody. Trying to go about day-to-day life, just then picked up some weight. It's easy to gain weight, but you got to be intentional in losing it. Amen, somebody. You got to be intentional in losing weight. And a good way to lose weight, and the reason some of us want to lose weight physically is because of our health. Amen. I didn't gain too much weight. Amen. We need to stop eating so much, amen. Go to the gym, but we have to not just be concerned about our physical health, but we need to be concerned about our spiritual health. Amen, somebody. Some of us have been weighted in our spirits. As we look at ourselves, one of the good ways to lose weight is exercise. Amen, somebody. If you want to lose weight, you have to exercise. And you got to do something. You got to be intentional. Amen. Somebody say intentional. You got to be intentional about losing weight. Amen. In the physical, just like you have to be concerned and intentional about losing weight in the spiritual. You got to exercise your faith. Amen, somebody. Just like you're intentional
about exercising. Amen. You got to be intentional about exercising your faith when you come in contact with the weight that you have gained. Preach, Turner. Amen. You got to be intentional. I heard you, Minister Burns. You said the scripture says in John 16 and 33, it said, in this world, you will have tribulation, but be of good cheer because I have overcome the world. The Bible says greater is he that is in me than he that is in the world. You got to exercise your faith. What do you mean, Pastor? You got to exercise the word that you say you got. Amen, somebody. Just like that gym membership, just like that treadmill, just like that bike you got to be intentional about getting on it. You got to be intentional about allowing the word of God to rise up in your spirit, and you got to exercise your faith. Preach, turn, amen. Not just my physical health, but my spiritual health, and I need some exercise if I'm going to lose this weight. This is the case here with our text today. These individuals, just in short, had been facing persecution. They had accepted the Lord Jesus as their Savior. They were Jews, and Jews, watch this, they did not necessarily accept their own kind. Jesus was a Jew. They did not accept the teachings and the principles and the precepts of Christ about being associated with Christ. They found themselves, Sister Mitchell, because of their association. They found themselves facing persecutions. Amen. I heard you, Deacon McGee, teaching the lesson. When there are sometimes when you're, because you're associated with Christ, people don't want to hang out with you no more. Amen, somebody. People see that you're coming to Bible study. People see your conversation is changing. Now you're adding a little flavor to your conversation because now you're talking about Jesus. Amen, somebody. And people are not so likely to call you now because your focus has shifted. Amen. Just like you become focused on losing that physical weight, your focus, you have to be intentional, and your focus has to shift. Amen, somebody. You got to understand your associations, and their associations led them to be persecuted. And they say, wait a minute, I didn't sign up for this. Just like some of us, we say, wait a minute, if God is real, why isn't he intervening? Why isn't he doing something about all of these problems? Amen. We need to understand it's not about God, but we got to look at the enemy. Because of man's choices. Because of man's, watch this, choice to do what God didn't say do. When mama told us not to touch the stove, she was telling us for a reason, because we'll get burned. And a lot of us have gotten burned in life in so many different areas. And now we understand it. And now we want somebody to help. Amen. But you got to understand, I don't care how much help you get, you still got to heal from the burn. There's still some pain that's associated with the burn. That's not because mama was wrong. That's because I did not obey. Amen. The word of God helps us to understand that if we obey the word, amen, we have to exercise our faith. That's why it said no weapon formed. There's a whole lot of weapons that form this year in our lives. But you got to look at the second clause. No weapon formed against us shall not prosper. It will form, but it will only prosper if I give it some power. Somebody missing what I'm saying? That missed over somebody's head. If the only reason it will prosper if I give it some power, but if I give it a word, it will not prosper. Then I will prosper because I have the power, because the word of God is power, because the word of God says that I can do all things through Christ that strengthens me. The word of God said, and I know that my God shall supply all my needs according to his riches and glory. I may not have a stimulus from the White House, but I got a stimulus from God's house. He said, I'll open up the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing that you don't have room enough to receive. Is there anybody in the house? No, that God will give me my stimulus. He's the sustainer of my mind. See, some of y'all have been fancy all your life. Always had a good job. Always had a good car. But is there anybody that had a Chevrolet? Amen. Like my grandmama said, you shove one foot and you lay the other. I never always had a car to drive. Sometime I had to walk. Sometime I had to catch the bus. But I'm so glad that God has sustained me. That God has kept me. What you see right now is not what I've always been. I was depressed. I didn't feel like giving up. I was preaching in the pulpit. I wanted to go somewhere and sit down. I said, Lord, where are you? But I'm so glad that the Holy Ghost rose up in me and said, hold on to God's unchanging hand. Yes, time is filled with swift transition, but I'm a hold on to God's unchanging hand. And the author here was telling these individuals, just hold on. Don't give up. I know you're not liking what you're going through. I know you don't appreciate now because you thought when you joined the church, everything was supposed to be all right. You thought when you joined the church, there would be no more sleepless night. You thought everybody would like you. But Peter said like this, blessed are those that suffer as a Christian. Amen. When you become a Christian, I know you suffered as a sinner, but you got to learn how to suffer as a saint. There's a difference between suffering as a sinner and suffering as a saint. See, when I suffered as a sinner, I didn't have nothing to hold me. I didn't have nothing to guide me. I didn't have nothing to direct me. But when I suffer as a saint, I got the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. When he was wounded for my transgression, he was bruised for my iniquity, and the chastisement of his peace was on his shoulder, and by his stripes, I wish I had a praying church. Is there anybody in the house that know there's a difference from suffering as a sinner and suffering as a saint? Because when I suffered as a saint, there was a word that sustained me. And he's telling these individuals, you just need to hold on a little while longer. I know it don't look good. I know it don't feel good. I know people are dying. I know people are in the hospital. I know you see all these corona cases. I know you see the president and Congress. They can't sign a stimulus package. I just don't know what to do. Is there anybody that ever been in a place? You don't know what to do. You don't know how you're going to make it. You don't know which way you go. But I heard somebody say, Sister Shirley, when I don't know which way to go, I know a way to go. I can go down on my knees and I can say, Father, I stretch my hand to thee. No other help I know. Is there anybody that ever had to call on the Lord? All of us need to wave our hands, because I know you weren't praying like you should have been praying, but I know God has been good to you, because guess what? I'm looking across this place. I see the viewers on Facebook. You're still here after all you've been through. When you didn't have the money, when you didn't have the job, when you didn't have a peace of mind, when you had confusion all around you, look at your neighbor. Say, neighbor, in the midst of it all, God kept me. God kept me. Saying, I know it don't look good, but he'll keep you in perfect peace if you keep your mind stayed on him. And he's telling him, all y'all have to do is hold on. I know y'all picked up some weight. Pick up the weight of persecution. I know you feel like going back to your old way of doing things. But all I want to do is encourage somebody as we prepare to cross over into a new year. I don't know if I'm going to make it to Friday. But I'm going to make a decision today that I'm going to release some stuff. Amen. I'm not going to wait till the new year. That's why some of y'all were shouting like y'all were shouting. That's why some of y'all were clapping like y'all were clapping, because you made up in your mind that it's time for me to shake myself loose. I've had some chains on me. I've had some stuff holding me down. But I made it up in my mind that I'm not going another day I'm not going another second. I'm not going another minute. I've learned that I gotta shake myself loose. Look at your neighbor. Say, neighbor, I've learned that I gotta shake myself loose. My spiritual health is important to me. And if I get my spirit right, my mind would be right. My body will be right. And if you're gonna lose some weight, you got to exercise. But sometimes, wait a minute, Tony, it gets a little difficult to exercise. He said, but you need some motivation. Look at somebody saying you need some motivation. See, motivation is the state or condition of being motivated or having a strong reason to accomplish your act of something. And I need some motivation. He says to the people, you need to look at the witnesses, those who've gone on before you, those who know what it's about. Just go back to chapter 11. As Moses, as Abraham, as Isaac, as Noah. If that's too far for y'all, you need to go back in your family history. You can ask Big Mama. You can ask Granddaddy. You can ask your uncles and your aunties, Mama and Daddy. Tell me how you made it. And when I look at their life, they were trusting in the same God that I put my trust in. And if God allowed them to make it, God will see me through. I'm motivated by what God has done in somebody else's life. When I look around this room, I get motivated because I see people that were depressed, that were defeated, that felt like giving up. But after all you've been through, you're still holding on. Say yes. I need some motivation if I'm going to lose some weight. I heard you, Deacon McGee, you got to associate with the right people. If you don't associate with the right people, they'll add more weight on you. They'll add more burdens on you. But I need somebody who can help me lift the heavy load in my life. Not only do I need motivation, I got to look at myself and do an evaluation. I got to determine the value or the amount of weight I'm going to lose. You got to stand on the scale sometime. You got to look at your life. You got to see what's burdening you. You got to see what's weighing you down. You got to appraise the situation and say, I'm too heavy. I'm too heavy. I need to get some weight off of me. I don't need to be depressed. I don't need to be defeated. I don't need to be discouraged. I don't need no more negative people in my life talking about the past while I'm looking into the future, trying to hold me down, trying to hold me back. Is there anybody in the house? You got to do an evaluation. You get on the scale to see how heavy you are. And when you get off the scale, you are determined to lose that weight. Just like you're determined to lose the physical pounds, you got to be determined to lose all the mental stress, all the spiritual stress. And you need at least three things. You need some discipline, determination, and dedication. You gotta be disciplined enough to get on that treadmill, to get on that bike, to lift those weights. You gotta be disciplined enough not to make the call. You gotta be disciplined enough not to believe what the report of the doctor. I know what you said. I accept what you said, but I'm going to believe the report of the Lord. Is there anybody in the house that's going to reevaluated and say, I'm going to be disciplined. I got to have the determination. I know it may be hard. I know it may not feel good. I know I may not feel like it. I know I don't want to cut it off, but I got to cut it off. I got to stop it right now if I want to lose some weight. Say yes. Say yes. Come on, Tony. Let's fly this plane. Is there anybody in the house that know you're determined that I'm going to be dedicated? I'm going to reach my goal. After evaluation, after motivation, then there's consummation. The Bible said that you're going to take off every weight and sin that besets you, that hinders you, that stops you from moving forward. Is there anybody in the house that knows that I will keep on moving? I will not stop. I will not die in the wilderness, but I'm going to reach my goal. Say yes. Oh, oh yes. After I do the evaluation to see what's hindering me, I'm going to keep on moving. I'm going to look at Jesus. After I looked at myself, after I looked at the witnesses, I'm going to look to Jesus for my consummation. What do you mean, Turner? Consummation is perfection and fulfillment. That Jesus, the same Jesus that died on the cross, that lived 33 years, they put him on the cross. Didn't they do it on the third day? He got up from the cross. Didn't he do it? Yes, he did. The same Jesus that evaluated, that was motivated, is the same Jesus that I'm going to look to help me lose some weight. He's my coach. He's my trainer. He's the perfecter and the sustainer. Ain't he all right? Yes, he is. Look at your name. Say, neighbor, don't give up. Keep on moving. It's time to lose some weight. It's time to go a little bit further. Yeah. Oh, yeah. I've been heavy too long. I've been trying to carry this load. But it's time to break myself loose. It's time. Oh, it's time. I'm tired of being sick and tired. I'm tired of being heavy. But I'm so glad. I'm so glad that God will, God will sustain me. God will keep me. Won't he do it? Look at your neighbor, and I'm on my way to my seat. Say, neighbor, in my good heart, but be not dismayed. Whatever betide, God will take care of you. He took care of me all year long, and I trust that God will take care of me the rest of my life. That's why I'm reminded of that old song, for the rest of my life, I'll serve the Lord. For the rest of my life, I'll give him glory. For the rest of my life, I'll give him praise. And be all right. No! Oh, 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 yeah! Thank you. It's time to lose some weight. Jesus said, come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden. I'll give you rest. You have to exercise your faith. That's the key to losing weight. I know some of you have been discouraged. Some of you have been in a dismal place. But I want to urge you, exhort you to continue to trust in the Lord. I know it's old, I know it's out of style. But keep on trusting. Keep on trusting in the Lord. I don't have nothing else to tell you. I don't know how much longer you're going to live. I'm going to live. But let me urge you. Make a recommendation. Keep on trusting in the Lord. Father God, we thank you now for this opportunity that you allowed us to worship today. Thank you, oh God, for your grace and your mercy that you've extended to us one more time. Father, we thank you for even reminding us that some of us are too heavy. It's time for us to lose some pounds, some inches in our spirit, oh God, so that we won't be overweight. But you told us to cast our cares upon you. You care for us. You can take it. We tried to carry it. We tried to tote the load. But we can't tote it no more. Help us, oh God, to release this load. And help us to keep our eyes on you. Father, we don't know if we're going to make it into another calendar year. But if you're never doing anything else, you've already done enough. We thank you, oh God, for keeping us as long as you kept us. And if we happen to live a little longer, like Grandmama said, if you allow our golden moments to roll on a little while longer, help us to be determined and disciplined and dedicated enough to keep our eyes on you. There may be somebody, oh God, who's hearing my voice, who have not trusted you, accepted you. We pray they'll open their heart to receive you in their life. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. We thank God for this opportunity to share with those of us who have tuned in via Facebook or YouTube. We pray something was said to encourage you, to motivate you, to challenge you to lose the weight that you have gained this year, a weight you have been carrying from years past. Be motivated by the witnesses. Do an evaluation of the weight that you need to lose. And then come to a place of consummation where you're looking at Christ for perfection and fulfillment. Thank you all for supporting our ministry all throughout this year, your prayers. Thank you for your gifts, how you've sown into this ministry. We love you and we thank you for tuning in. And if it's God's willing, we'll see you at the first Sunday in 2021. God bless you and God keep you. If you want to become a disciple of this local ministry, you can come to this ministry. Our phone number is 219-949-2225. Don't let the day make the difference in you, but you make the difference in the day. God bless you. Let us stand. There may be somebody here today